Hello everyone, my name is Trevor and this is my review of The Power of the Dog. It is a gorgeously directed neo-western from Jane Campion, featuring a phenomenal ensemble cast. Jane Campion is back! For the first time in 12 years, Jane Campion has released a new film and it was worth the wait. When it comes to Campion, I'm pretty basic. The Piano is my favorite of her films, I know. But overall, I love Campion's filmmaking style. All of her films just feel, like, real. They're incredibly immersive, and regardless of the time or the setting, they feel so true and so raw. And The Power of the Dog is no different. I mentioned the ensemble, and let's talk about it. Benedict Cumberbatch stars alongside Jesse Plemons as Phil and George Burbank. Kirsten Dunst stars as Rose Gordon, who falls in love with George, and Cody Smit-mcphee plays her son. Also, Thomasin McKenzie is just kind of like here for no apparent reason, but she's here. The plot of The Power of the Dog is as follows. A domineering rancher responds with mocking cruelty when his brother brings home a new wife and her son until the unexpected comes to pass. I love how vague that plot synopsis is, because this I don't want to go too into spoilers on this. But non-spoilery, The Power of the Dog is just like gorgeous in every way. It feels so methodical and plotting the entire time. It never feels like there is a true moment of escalation into the climax, but the escalation of tension is happening the whole time. I just didn't notice until the credits rolled and I felt like I was about to have a heart attack. There are so many factors at play here to make this work. The first is that Campion just directs the crap out of this movie. She understands filmmaking just completely and entirely. I don't know how to describe it. She just, like, she gets it. Ari Wegner's cinematography is also hauntingly gorgeous. I want to stay as spoiler-free as possible, like I said, but it conveys so much about each character with every single shot. It's truly inspiring cinematography. Lastly, but definitely not least, is Johnny Greenwood's score. He's 2 for 2 on the year. Between this and Spencer, Licorice Pizza, still to come. It's out, but only in New York and LA. I will be seeing it soon. This is the perfect Western score. It feels like dusty and dark and sad, but with like this weird energy that I can't place my finger on that makes it like exciting. It's like an excited depression, but like dusty. I'm not doing it justice at all. Just like go listen to it. Again, I'll keep on reiterating because I don't want people to say that I'm not going into too much detail. I am trying to stay as spoiler-free as possible. I really want people to experience this movie as fresh as possible. But the themes that Jane Campion addresses here are really deeply planted. And much like everything else, they slowly escalate without you noticing. The seeds rise to the soil, to do a metaphor. She has some really interesting takes on masculinity pertaining to the juxtaposition of Benedict Cumberbatch and Cody Smit-McPhee's characters, ideas about addiction and the never-ending circle of sexism causing addiction, causing more sexism because they're addicted and they're acting a bit strange, and then that just causes more addiction to cope, etc. Again, it's so hard for me not to keep talking, but I want to keep this as spoiler-free. Just go watch the movie. I really, really love it. I wouldn't say it's perfect. It does have some weird pacing, but other than a few minor gripes, Campion does pretty much everything right here in this cast. That seg ensemble, please. Speaking of awards, it's awards talk time. All right, so production design and costumes. I have seen some people bring these up. I am not convinced. Those categories are just way too strong this year for this to happen. Like they're good, the production design and costumes, but they're nothing like special or that we haven't seen. Like it's like they're really, really good, but they're just like kind of building off of what's been done in the past. They aren't doing anything revolutionary, and we've seen some really great period pieces, and other just really like Dune, for instance, like just really great takes on those two aspects of filmmaking that I think would be really hard for this to break in. Cinematography, though, should absolutely happen for Ari Wegner. I think it will. It's probably number 3 behind Dune and Tragedy of Macbeth. I feel pretty good about cinematography. Editing is tricky. I think some places will throw it in. We saw the Satellite Awards give it editing. So this could happen. It really contributes to the tension building that I talked about. And yes, there are some pacing issues, but I think it's mostly just because of how methodical and plotting this film is. And it's very much for a reason. So I can give it a bit of a pass on that. So I wouldn't be opposed to seeing the editing in here, but it also isn't like the flashiest of editing, which is what the Academy typically goes for. Johnny Greenwood's score should get in, unless for some reason they decide, well, we're only going to do one Greenwood score. Like, Spencer and Power of the Dog are very, very strong. Licorice Pizza just outside. I mean, I'll be very mad if this does not get in. Both of the scores are absolutely incredible. I can't imagine they would just pick one. So yeah, I'm feeling pretty good about score. Supporting actor for both Jesse Plemons and Cody Smit-McPhee. Cody Smit-McPhee might be my favorite supporting actor performance of the year. Jesse Plemons is also pretty up there. Jesse Plemons might also be category fraud. He could be considered a lead, but they won't put both Cumberbatch and Plemons in lead. The same could be said about Kirsten Dunst, who's going into supporting actress. But for both of them, I think all three of them could get in. This could get three supporting nominations, and I think they would all be deserved. But you will not hear me stopping saying this. That was horrible grammar. But you won't hear me not say this for a while in this award season. The supporting categories are messy. Messy, messy, messy. To quote the magician from Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, they are very, very messy. We have absolutely no clue what's going to happen. So I would feel confident about Cody Smit-McPhee and Kirsten Dunst. I think that McPhee is stronger than Plemons. So if they only pick one, which they do that sometimes with the acting categories, if they only pick one, I think Smit-McPhee will probably get in. I also see him getting the big Critics' Choice boost that Plemons probably won't have. Best actor for Benedict Cumberbatch. He's pretty in there. He might even be the number two to Will Smith at this point. Like, he's very in there. I would say that he's one of the locks alongside Denzel. I'm feeling very good about Benedict Cumberbatch getting in. He's very, very good in the role. He's very commanding. It's not something that we've ever seen Cumberbatch do before. He does an accent. I mean, he's British, so of course. But he even does, like, this would be an accent for an American actor. He's doing quite a bit. Best director for Jane Campion. Honestly, she could win. Seriously, I think that Jane Campion could win Best Director. I know people will say, well, Kenneth Branagh, but what about Paul Thomas Anderson? I don't think Belfast maintains its momentum. For now, it would be dumb not to predict Belfast. But I don't, like, maybe a month from now, I don't think we see that Belfast is still the consensus number one. If that happens, Branagh is no lock to win Director. Then it opens up. I think Campion happens. The narrative is there, her first film in 12 years. This would be like her first nomination in like 15 or 20. Like, the narrative is there. She beautifully directs this. It's easily one of the best directed films of the year. This could 100% happen. And hey, you know, roll the tape if she wins 5 months from now. I'm honestly considering predicting her at number one for best director for the next Oscars prediction video I do. I'm very seriously considering that. And lastly, Best Picture. I mean, of course, with all the things that, like, it's definitely getting nominated for a director, definitely getting an actor nomination. At least one supporting nomination will happen. Score is happening. Cinematography is happening. We don't know about editing or some of the other supportings, but, like, it's getting Best Picture. It's getting Best Picture. This was the front runner to win before Belfast took over. There's no way it falls so far that it will just be completely outside. Feeling very, very good about predicting this in Best Picture. And it's probably a top five. It's probably a top five at this point. But that is my review of The Power of the Dog. I will be giving the film a 9 out of 10. I really, really loved it. But comment your thoughts on The Power of the Dog down below. Thank you for watching the review. If you want to see more movie reviews and more Oscars content, please consider subscribing.